Professor Nanisha Goswami, you are welcome in online series of machine design. So in today's session, I am going to cover about internal combustion engine. And in internal combustion engine, we will learn how to design a valve. So we have seen already in previous lectures design of valve and basic fundamentals for valve. So here I will use one numerical example so you can understand better how to find out the different dimension of either head, either face. So you can find out the different dimensions by using the proper designing, by using a numerical example. Okay, so I will just revise the in 1-2 minutes all fundamentals that we have already covered in previous lectures, right? So to designing a valve, it is required to determine what are the dimensions we have to require to find out the different dimensions. Okay, so designing a valve, first of all we have to find out the size of valve port. So how to find out the size of valve port? So here we consider the area of port and mean velocity of the gas flowing through the port, and by considering the so how much fluid will be flow through the port. So whatever amount of discharge will be available from your piston, so that discharge of fluid go through your valve port. So that's why we have to consider here area of piston and mean velocity of your piston in meter per second. Okay, so by equating the discharge, so discharge between port and your piston should be equal. So discharge for the port is APVP is equal to discharge in piston is equal to area into velocity. So meter cube per second or mm cube per second, what will be the standard dimension you can take, right? So by using this fundamental, we can find out the AP. Okay, so AP is your area of force, that is equal to discharge of piston divided by mean velocity of your gas which is flowing through the port, right? So mean velocity we have already seen in last lecture for low speed engine and for high speed engine, for particular case of inlet valve and for particular case of your exhaust valve. So this is for low speed engine. For inlet condition it varies from the 33 to 40 in meter per second, right? And for high speed it varies from the 80 to 90. Similarly, mean velocity of the gas for exhaust valve, it is varies from 40 to 50 and from 90 to 100. So 40 to 50 for low speed engine, 90 to 100 for high speed engine. Okay, so by using this you can find out the area of the port, right? So sometimes area of the port or inlet port is made of 20 to 40% larger than your exhaust port for the battery cylinder charging, that I have already explained in last lecture. Okay, so second thing is you have to find out the thickness of valve disc or valve head. Okay, disc and head both are the same thing. Okay, so it's it is denoted by D, right? So you can find out directly using the empirical formula. So here formula is T is equal to, that I have already explained, right? T is equal to K into BP under root of P divided by sigma B. So here K is your constant. So for steel, its value varies from 0.42 for steel and 0.54 for cast iron. Okay? And P is your maximum gas pressure. Sigma B is your allowable bending stresses. BP is your here diameter of the port. Okay? So stresses are always considered in megapascal. Its value for the cast to carbon steel, its value is 50 to 60 megapascal and 100 to 120 megapascal for the alloy steel. So these are the constant value you can take it, right? Next is you have to find out the maximum lift of the valve. Lift means how much jump of the valve maybe takes place. So that is known as your lift of valve. Okay, so we consider the conical section. So by using the area, okay, or by equating the area of valve seat to the area of conical valve. Okay, so this is your conical or area of your sheet. So by creating these two fundamentals, we can find out the h. So h is equal to dp divided by 4 cos alpha, and alpha is also varies from 30 to 45 degree. Okay, and when we use the flat headed ball, so its value h is equal to dp by 4. Right? Now we will do the last portion, ball stem diameter. So we have already seen that middle portion is known as ball stem diameter, and DS value is standard. So its value varies from dp divided by 8 to 6.35 and dp divided by 8 plus 11 times of your mm. Okay, so these are the standard value. Now we have to take one example. The conical ball of IC engine is 60 mm in diameter, and it is subjected to maximum gas pressure is equal to 4 Newton per mm square. Means maximum gas pressure is how much? So P is equal to 4 Newton per mm square. Okay. The safe stress in bending for the ball material is 46 megapascal. So how much? 46 megapascal means its value is equal to 46 Newton per mm square. Okay. And the ball is made of steel for which K is equal to 0.42. Okay, so constant K value is also given. The angle at which the ball's this seat is tapered is 30 degree, means alpha angle is given. Okay, so now we have to find out the thickness of the ball head, stem diameter, and maximum length of the ball. So you have to find out the three fundamentals. Okay, so given, first of all, write down the given data. So dp is given how much? So dp is equal to diameter of ball is given 60 mm. And P is equal to 4 Newton per mm, so this is your maximum pressure. dP is diameter of 4. Sigma P is your allowable maximum bending stresses, so 46 megapascal. So its value is equal to 46 Newton per mm square. K is constant given 0.40. Alpha is given 30 degree, right? So what is the solution? So first of all, we have to find out the thickness of the ball head, right? So what is the thickness of the ball head? We have the empirical formula. So we will directly put, we will use this formula. So T is equal to K into dP under root of P divided by sigma B. So P maximum pressure we have, sigma B we have, K we have, and dP we have. So I will just put the all values in this equation. So you will get the 7.43. So approximate this thickness of the ball head is equal to 7.5 mm, right? Next is your stem diameter. So what is the stem diameter? So its value already constant we have seen in design procedure. So just we will put the value of dp. So dp is 60 divided by 8 plus 6.35. So you will get the 13.85, or approximate you can say that 14 mm, right? Next is your maximum lift of the ball. So maximum lift of the ball is h is equal to dp divided by 4 cos alpha. So alpha is given, its value is 30 degree. So just put the value, you will get the h. Okay, so h is equal to 60 divided by 4 times of cos 30. And finally, you will get the answer 17.4 mm. Okay, so you will get the 17.4 mm. Okay, so this is the maximum lift of your ball, right? So, thank you. Keep watching.